Hi, I'm Xaq Pitkow. I'm going to tell you about an overview of the material that you'll cover in Neuromatch Academy so that you can know what to expect you might be able to use for your projects. So in the projects, you're going to apply what you've learned in the course, but you may also want to find some new techniques on your own that you research to apply. And so the question arises, what should you find on your own and what can you expect to cover already in the course and when? The 10,000-foot view is that our 3 weeks are divided roughly into what, why, and how models, descriptive, normative, and mechanistic, as we covered in the first day. On week one, you'll talk about model fitting on Wednesday, linear models on Thursday, and dimensionality reduction on Friday. Let's dive into these a little more. On Wednesday, you'll get into the basics of model fitting, doing parameter estimation, and then evaluating how good those models are. You're going to practice this with linear models, which is one of the core foundations of data analysis, and you'll expand a little bit to some simple nonlinear models. On the next day, you'll generalize that to GLMs, or generalized linear models, which are more flexible variants that are good for a wider variety of data types, especially spiking data, for example. You'll also learn how to fit models that integrate information over time, or instead of giving continuous outputs, to use linear models for classifiers, for categorical outputs. And then, in order to impose some structure, you'll learn how to apply regularizers. These are common tools that you'll see again and again in many papers, and these are things you may want to apply. On Friday, you'll learn about another tool commonly used, dimensionality reduction, which allows you to simplify complicated data. The most common of these is principal components analysis, and we'll spend a bunch of time on that, learning about how to sample multivariate Gaussian data and how to decompose that data into simpler representations. And we'll touch on a little bit of nonlinear methods, for example, t-SNE. In week two, we'll talk about normative models. These are models that say what should an animal do when confronted with a given task. We'll talk in the beginning about foundations in Bayesian inference, then we'll talk about time, when things evolve over time, have dynamics. We'll talk about decisions, and then how you use those decisions to control things or act. And finally, when you don't know exactly the structure of the world and have to learn it, we use reinforcement learning to describe that process. Let's again dive in a little bit here. In Bayesian inference, you'll cover the rules of probability, how you use them, and the running examples that you'll see will be binary variables and normal or Gaussian variables. You'll learn how you can optimally combine evidence from different sources and optimally ignore irrelevant variables as well. In day two, we'll take these ideas and use them to describe dynamics. We'll focus on Markov models, where the update of some system depends only on its current state. We'll concentrate on linear dynamical systems, which is a very good way of understanding how things change over time. Even when things are nonlinear, the tools that you learn in linear dynamical systems will carry you a great deal of the way towards understanding nonlinear dynamics, although things can get much more complicated. We'll also talk about stochasticity, or random processes. Now, if the world behaves that way, but you don't get to see it exactly, you only get partial observations, then the world is hidden to you, and we call that a hidden Markov model. And the variables of interest are latent, another word for hidden. You'll learn how to handle these variables and to accumulate evidence about them, which is what we imagine that animals are doing as they move around the world. One of the most common variants of this type of inference in hidden Markov models is the Kalman filter. It uses linear dynamical systems with Gaussian noise to figure out how to track a variable that's moving in the world. So this is a very common technique, and you'll use it for dynamical systems all over the place, even tracking eyes and tracking prey or predators. It's a common tool that you'll probably want to use at some point. Now, once we've inferred latent variables in the world, you'll want to act. And this is the domain of optimal control. If you're doing normative modeling, this tells you the best way to control yourself, to control your actions in the world. And so we talk about movement and action, You'll learn about policies, which is a strategy for what to do in any given state. And we'll develop the mathematical foundations using Markov decision processes, both for a fully or partially observed world. Now, this is optimal control, where you know the world dynamics, you know the world structure. But if you don't know it and have to learn, you can learn that by reinforcement learning, where you have to trade off between exploring and figuring out what's there versus exploiting and using what you know. We'll talk about model-based and model-free strategies and ways of updating your model, including temporal difference learning. So all of that is the normative models, and you might use this if you're doing a project thinking about a task where an animal has to actually get some reward, like find the food. In week three, we'll talk about mechanistic models. Here we'll talk about real neurons and what happens when you connect many real neurons together. In terms of mechanism, these are thought to be causal, so we'll talk a lot about causality. We'll dedicate a whole day to thinking about how that differs from conventional analyses that you've seen earlier in the course. And then at the end of the week, we'll talk about deep learning, which could be a mechanistic model for the brain, or more often a descriptive model for the kind of nonlinear transformations that the brain might have to do. And finally, at the end of the week, your projects will be done and it will be time to present them. At the beginning of the week, we'll talk about real neurons, including the ion channels that allow currents to flow in and out of the cells, the cable equations that describe the passive dynamics as electrical activity propagates down axons and dendrites, the active conductances that give rise to spikes of activity in the neurons, synchrony that describes how those spikes come together between different neurons, and synaptic plasticity, which adjusts the connections between those neurons. When you have bigger networks, you can think about them collectively, and we'll talk about moving from spiking networks to rate models. These models tend to be nonlinear, so you need to use some different tools, including based on the linear systems that you saw earlier, but also thinking about local linearization, giving you fixed points, and thinking about flow fields or vector fields that describe the global structure of how things change over time in a network. And we'll talk about inhibition-stabilized network, which is a variant of neural networks which have specific properties related to the inhibitory-excitatory balance that comes about in the brain. In day three, we'll talk about causality, and we'll contrast correlation and causation. There's a common tool that people use to approximate causality called Granger causality that's useful in time series. You'll learn about that. And in causal analysis, you'll learn about confounders and interventions and instrumental variables. These are ways that you will be able to start to assess whether two signals are related to each other in a causal way or merely a correlational way. So this can be a good tool, but you'll have to learn about that before you apply it, because this is coming at the end of the course. And then the last 2 days will be dedicated to deep learning, which is a very popular emerging technique these days, or a tool to describe nonlinear relationships between things that you can learn. We'll base our learning on PyTorch, which is a framework, a programming environment, a programming language to use neural networks and learn in neural networks. It's very convenient. We'll think about artificial neural networks, which you're going to be programming up with PyTorch, and how you can understand how information is encoded into those networks and decoded from them, and autoencoders, which is a way of putting those two together. And one of the examples that you'll look at is convolutional networks, where you have something, a network that performs the same operations at all places in space, which is a very popular approach to image processing. Because images have similar statistics across space. So this allows you to use the structure of the world. So these could be viewed as mechanistic models if things match well, or they're descriptive models. So that gives you a big overview of the whole set of content in the Neuromatch Academy. Most projects are going to use tools from week one. They're both more approachable, and of course earlier in the course. You might use some material from week two. It's going to be hard to use material from week three in your projects, because you'll only see it at the end of the class when your project is more mature. But you can think about that material anyway on your own and bring it into the project if you like. But we encourage you to use the tools that we're giving you because that will enrich your understanding of them as you experience them. But yes, you can go beyond that material and find new things as you see fit. So I've presented you a bunch of information about the tools that you will learn, but I want to emphasize that you should really focus on the scientific question, not the tool. And that's what we're trying to have you learn in doing the projects, is focus on what you're trying to ask, how you can answer it, and why that's an important question. Now, also, I want to mention that in science, most of the things that we try don't work, and that's okay. But what you can do is learn from the mistakes, learn from the things that work, learn from the things that don't work, and enjoy the process. So overall, have fun. Thanks very much.